Hello and welcome back to the Houston Texans franchise. Today we will battle the Kansas City Chiefs here on Super Bowl Sunday. Hopefully the Rams and Bengals make the Super Bowl as exciting as this game I'm about to bring you here. The Texans are coming off their first loss on the season, looking to bounce back, and the Chiefs, they are also coming off a loss, sitting at 6-2 in second place in their division behind the Broncos. This game is going to have a huge impact on the AFC when it comes to the playoffs, so obviously both teams want to win. Patrick Mahomes, the quarterback for the Chiefs, he is having yet another great season. He's a 99 overall, superstar X-factor, he can make any throw on the field, and on top of that, he is also mobile. And the Chiefs, they have done a great job of surrounding him with excellent talent. Eric Hauser, a former Heisman winner, Tyreek Hill, Travis Kelce, even Alan Lazard. The Chiefs might have the best roster here in our franchise. We do have the goal to beat the Chiefs and hold Mahomes to under 75 rushing yards. We do have plus 5 play rec to try to get that done, which is good because you remember we did lose 15 morale for the entire team after we failed the goal to beat the Titans and force a bunch of turnovers. But we'll worry about defense later because Dwight Devine and the Texans offense is going to start with the ball. Here's Willis getting a carry on first down, picking up nothing. Second and 10. Devine, a quick throw underneath to Chase Claypool. Picking up about 8 yards there. Third and 2. Devine going to try to throw for it. Has plenty of time, going over the middle, nearly intercepted. It probably should have been. It looked like Cole Beasley just let the cornerback cross his face and jump the route. And yep, that is exactly what happened. So it's a quick 3-and-out for the Texans, and the Chiefs take over after a punt. Here is Eric Hauser with a reception and a first down in of 12. He is the leading receiver currently for the Chiefs. Mahomes moving left here on first down. Hit me, lost the ball. The Texans are on it, and they're going to take over at the Chiefs 31. An early mistake here by Patrick Mahomes. He thought he could get the throw off, but Andrew Van Ginkle had other plans. And a nice job by Ross Blacklock there to dive on it just in time. So great starting field position here for the Texans. It's going to be a read option for Devine. He has a first down out of bounds at the 18, putting the Texans in the red zone. A handoff here on first down to Willis. Cutting right side, running over a defender. Inside the 5, down at the 3. It is goal to go. First and goal. Goes up the middle. He's going to be met by a bunch of defenders and stuffed in the backfield, losing 4 yards. Second and goal. Devine going underneath, and it's incomplete in the dirt, intended for Davante Adams. Third and goal. Devine, nobody really open, moving right. Going underneath to Joe Scott. He's going to be stopped there at about the 4, and it is fourth down. So a great job there by the Chiefs to hold the Texans to a field goal after the great starting field position. Chiefs down 3-0 after that turnover, but still have a chance to take the lead if they can go down the field and score a touchdown. Third and 8 here. Mahomes going right side. It's intercepted. That is Desmond King jumping around inside the 20. This is going to be a pick 6 as the Texans take an early 2-score lead here in the first quarter. Mahomes making another mistake here early. I mean, King read that all the way, jumped that route, and nobody's going to catch him when he only has to go that far. Now down 10-0 here early in the first quarter with 5.5 to go in it. Mahomes going deep down the field, caught by Tyreek Hill. He just mossed Roman Davis. Despite the early interception and the early fumble, Mahomes, he's still a gunslinger. He's going to chuck it down the field and let his playmakers make plays. Here's a handoff to Clyde Edwards-Helaire. And up nothing on the play. Second and 10. Mahomes going right side. That is Alan Lazard. Up to the 16, putting the Chiefs in the red zone. Clyde Edwards-Helaire left side. He has a decent gain here, down at the 10. Second and 3. Texans blitz, a quick throw right side by Mahomes. That is a touchdown for Travis Kelce as the Chiefs drive right down the field, answering back after the mistake, and make this a 7-10 Texans lead. Houston back on offense here as Devine has all day in the pocket. Taking a shot down the field for Cole Beasley, and he's got him. Across midfield to the Kansas City 47. That'll make up for Beasley's earlier mistake where he let the defensive back cross his face and nearly intercept it. Devine finds Mitchell down the field a bit here, and he has a first down up to the 31. First and 10, Willis on a counter left side, and he's going to have another first down up to the 21. Texans offense humming along so far. Willis cutting up middle, and he's near another first down. Getting over 120 yards last week despite the loss, and he's off to a fast start in this one. Second and inches. The Chiefs blitz. Devine over the middle, caught by Beasley, and he's into the end zone, extending this Texans lead here in the first quarter That is Beasley's first touchdown as a member of the Houston Texans. We still have a minute and a half left here in this first quarter as the Chiefs are back on offense, down 17-7. Alan Lazard picking up 7 yards on first down. Second and 3, Clyde Edwards-Helaire left side, stiff-arming Jacoby Stevens, and he has a first down for the 29. Mahomes all day in the pocket. Stepping up, going right side for Kelce. He has a first down out of bounds up at the 42. Mahomes' only incompletion on the day is that pick 6. He hits Kelce again here. He's across midfield for the Houston 44, ending our first quarter finally. The Texans defense looking to get a stop and get the ball back to the offense here. But the Chiefs, they're looking to cut this down to a one-score game. There is Alan Lazard is out of bounds there. Second and 10. Quick throw underneath to who else but Travis Kelce. And he has a first down up to the 31. Play action fake to Clyde Edwards-Helaire. Pressure on Mahomes going down the field. It's intercepted. Mahomes' third turnover of this first half. That is Justin Reed getting the interception and taking it up to the 17, where the Texans' offense will take over. The pressure was right in Mahomes' face, and he forced it down the field into double coverage. Reed ready there to make a play. So the Texans looking to increase this lead. They're going to hand it off to Leonard Fournette. He picks up 6 yards on his first carry of the day. Second and 4, James White. He is stuffed in the backfield, losing 2 yards. Third down. Third and 6, the Chiefs blitz. Devine going down the field. He overshoots Joe Scott. It's a quick 3 and out, and the Chiefs are going to take back over. There are Mahomes' stats so far on the day. Despite his turnovers, he has been very efficient. See if he can cut those turnovers out and be even more efficient. Second and 7, Helaire up the middle. He has a first down up near the 40 to the 39. Mahomes, pressure on him. Quick throw underneath to Clyde Edwards-Helaire, picking up a couple. Bringing up second and 3. Chiefs go empty. Quick throw left side to Tyreek Hill. He breaks a tackle and is across midfield to the Houston 40. They haven't used Tyreek Hill really too much besides that one deep shot. Here is Juan Maxwell, a rookie running back out of Louisville, picking up 12 yards on his first carry and a first down. Now second and 7. Clyde Edwards-Helaire cutting back near a first down up to the 19. Third and 1. Promotioning Eric Hauser across. They fake it to him and give it to Helaire going back left, and he's going to be stopped short of the line again, bringing up fourth down. And the Chiefs, they are going to kick a field goal to make this a 10-17 Texans lead here in the second quarter. Under 5 minutes to go in this second quarter as Devine and the Texans take back over. Devine taking a shot down the field. That's Devontae Adams behind the defense. It's going to be a one-play touchdown for the Texans as they go right back up 2 scores. And now they've scored 24 points here in this first half. The offense hasn't been really great all season long, but they're getting some help from the defense and making some big plays down the field for once. Down 24-10, the Chiefs are back on offense. They're going to get a touchdown this time. There's Clyde Edwards-Helaire losing a yard on first down. Now 3rd and 8. Mahomes, quick throw down the field to Eric Hauser, and he has a first down up to the 41. 3:30 to go in the second quarter. Mahomes all day stepping up, going over the middle to Travis Kelce, and he's to the Houston 48. Now down to 3 minutes left in the first half. Mahomes, quick throw underneath to Tyreek Hill up to the 40. The Houston defense still has yet to force a punt. All their stops have come from turnovers as Clyde Edwards-Helaire is stopped down at the line of scrimmage. 3rd and 2, hearing the 2-minute warning. Mahomes moving right. He's going to take off. He has the first down. Finally going to slide on down at the 23. Remember, the Texans do have the goal to try to stop Mahomes and hold him to less than 75 rushing yards. So a pickup of 16 does put that a little bit in danger. 2nd and 2 after a nice gain there on first down. Mahomes stepping up, going to the end zone one-on-one, caught by Alan Lazard. He wins a jump ball and has made this a one-score game again here before the end of the first half. The Texans got a minute 25 left here in all their timeouts. Devine going to hit Joe Scott on the left side. Up to the 35, going out of bounds, stopping the clock and saving all these timeouts. Devine extending right, and he's got to check it down to Willis, but he falls down in bounds, so the Texans have to waste a timeout there. 2nd and 5. The Chiefs are going to blitz. Devine extending right, lobbing downfield, caught by Nico Collins. It's going to be a foot race and he's going to win. Another big play touchdown for the Houston Texans as they extend their lead back up to 2 scores. They have now put up 31 points here in the first half. All these Chiefs blitzes are just not working. And of all people, Nico Collins burns the defense. Not really known for his blazing speed. I mean, he's still pretty fast, but Not really a blazer. Made a big play, though, and now put the Texans back up two scores, and the Chiefs, they got a minute left and had to use a timeout there, so now just two timeouts, but plenty of time for them to do something. Added away there on first down by Michael Barr. 52 seconds left. Mahomes standing there, pressure on him finally, going down the field. It's going to be incomplete, bringing up third down. Third and 10. Mahomes all day. Nobody open, stepping up. He's going to take off and slide on down, bringing up fourth down, which would result in a punt, and that would take us to halftime. So the Texans lead here at half, 31-17. Defense making some big splash plays. The offense making some big plays down the field. It was a great first half all around for the Texans. We'll see if the fireworks can continue here in the second half. Kansas City will start the third quarter with possession. Quick throw on the right side to Kelce. He breaks a tackle, and he's still going. He's finally going to be spun on down at the Houston 47 by Adam Wiener. It's a big play to start the second half for the Chiefs. Play action fake here on first down, and that's off the hands of Kelce, incomplete. Third and 10. The Texans rush four. All day from Mahomes. He's going to check it down left side to Allaire, and he's stopped short of the first, bringing up fourth down. Chiefs are going to leave their offense on the field here. They're going to risk early in this second half, and it's going to pay off as Allaire gets the job done and takes it up to the 37. They give it to him on first down, and he's going to have a great gain, picking up another first down up to the 23. Just outside the red zone, the Chiefs go empty. Mahomes lobbing to the end zone for Allen Lazard. He's going to hang on through a tough hit there by Michael Barr. It is his second touchdown of this game, and he's made it a one-score game again. I mean, this is just a great throw by Mahomes, putting it where Allen Lazard is only going to win that jump ball. No chance for Michael Barr, really. Did put a good hit on Lazard, but it just didn't end up breaking it up. So the Texans up seven here, facing a third and six. All day for Devine, but there is nobody open. Spinning out left. He's just going to have to get rid of it. So it's a quick three and out for the Texans to start this second half on offense. The Chiefs take back over. Looking to tie us up here at 31. There is Travis Kelce picking up a bunch of yards up to the 43. Now second and seven. Mahomes going to hit Kelce again. He has another first down. Taking this to the Houston 42. Chiefs offense humming along here in this second half. All day from Mahomes going down the field. Caught by Tyreek Hill. He just burned Michael Barr and has tied us up here at 31. It is Mahomes' fourth passing touchdown of the game. And man, oh man, is Michael Barr having a rough day. First getting burned by Allen Lazard on a couple of jump balls. And now a deep shot to Tyreek Hill. Tied up at 31 here with 5 minutes left in the third quarter. Texans back on offense looking to get the lead back. Devine just inaccurate there on first down, intended for Devonta Adams. Second and 10. This one is at Chase Claypool's feet. So back-to-back inaccurate throws by Devine. Third and 10. He is extending right, throwing back across his body. Caught by Claypool up at the 40. Well, a great throw there. Keeps the drive alive. Second and 6. Plenty of time. Devine over the middle. Caught by Cole Beasley, rolling on the ground at the Kansas City 33. Back-to-back great throws by Devine there after two bad ones. Second and 9. Devonta Adams on a slant route. Brings up third and 3. Play action fake. Devine booting out right. Has a couple of people open. Going to go to Joe Scott. He's inside the 5 and down there. Going to be goal to go for the Texans. First and goal. Chance to get the lead back. Here is Willis going to be met and stopped right away. They actually say he lost a yard. Second and goal. Texans motion out white. Devine to the end zone, nearly intercepted. That ball had to be to the back of the end zone, not in the middle of it. Third and goal. Devine extending right. Nobody open. He has to take off inside the 5, and it's a touchdown. He tiptoes his way on in, giving the Texans the lead back here in the third quarter. What a great game we have going on here so far, 38-31. Chiefs trying to put together another drive here to get us tied back up. Here is Clyde Edwards-Helaire picking up a couple of yards on a screen pass. Now they hand it off to him on 2nd and 7, and he's going to pick up a first down up to the 40. They get three straight touches for Clyde Edwards-Helaire. He's across midfield, inside the Houston 40, finally shoved out at the 38. 17 carries, 84 rushing yards. He's having a pretty solid day running the ball, as Kelce picks up 5 yards there, ending the third quarter. 2nd and 5 to start the 4th. Mahomes downfield for Kelce, and he has a first down up to the 21, putting the Chiefs just outside the red zone. Clyde Edwards-Helaire up the middle. He's going to have a great gain on first down up to the 13, nearing 100 yards on the day. Chiefs go empty here. Mahomes, plenty of time. Moving left, going underneath to Allen Lazard, and he's up to the 5. 2nd and 5 from the 5. Only a 3-man rush. Mahomes to the end zone, incomplete off the hands of Alan Lazard. Would have been his third touchdown of the game. Third and five. Mahomes to the end zone, caught by Alan Lazard. He ends up getting it on the next play. He has doubled his season total here in just one game and has tied us up at 38. The Texans back on offense here as we have 8 minutes left in the fourth quarter and are all tied up at 38. Willis loses 2 yards on first down, second and 12. Devine, plenty of time going right side. He overshoots Devontae Adams. It is incomplete. Third and 12. Another clean pocket. Devine goes left side for Adams, and this time he hits him, and he has a first down up to the 35, keeping the drive going. Second and 6, Willis up the middle, runs into his own lineman and falls down, losing a yard. Third and 7. Devine stepping up, going over the middle. It is batted away and incomplete, bringing up fourth down. For the Texans, send on Dom Booth to try to pin the Chiefs back deep on a punt. It will bounce at the 5 and go out of bounds at the 7. So a great job by Dom Booth, making the Chiefs now have to go 93 yards to score a touchdown as Mahomes throws incomplete on first down. Second and 10, they stay empty. Mahomes running right, and he runs into Adam Wiener. It's going to be a safety, and the Texans have taken the lead here in the fourth quarter, 40-38. What a way to get the lead back in the fourth quarter in a game this high scoring on a safety of all plays. And on top of all that, they get the ball back on offense. So a chance to make this a two-score game. As Devine hits Claypool underneath, he's going to have a first down up to the 48. You got to give credit to this Texans offensive line. They haven't given up a sack yet and have held up really well. As Willis gets a carry on first down here, picking up nothing. Third and 10, 4:40 to go in the fourth quarter. Screen pass left side is blown up, intended for Devontae Adams. This play had no chance from the start because Laramie Tunsil missed a block. The Texans got to punt it away, and the Chiefs, they have a chance to take the lead with just a field goal here in the fourth quarter. Flip pass forward to Eric Hauser. He's going to be up to the 28, making it second and 2. Mahomes is just going to hand this off to Clyde Edwards-Helaire. He is stuffed down in the backfield by Ross Blacklock, bringing up third down, third and 3. Mahomes all day going over the middle, off the hands of Clyde Edwards-Helaire, incomplete. A perfect throw from Mahomes, but Clyde Edwards-Helaire couldn't pay it off. So the Texans are going to get the ball back on offense. They have a chance to run this one out. But Willis has really cooled off after that hot start. And they get him going again. Play action fake to him. Devine downfield, caught by Claypool. And he's up to the 44 with a huge gain. Now under 3 minutes to go. Willis up the middle, running ahead to the 46. Not much space. Second and 8, the 2 minute warning approaching. The clock's going to stop anyway, so the Texans take a deep shot down the field. It is incomplete, intended for Devontae Adams. Third down. Third and 8, the Texans go empty. Pressure on Devine, going downfield, incomplete, intended for Devontae Adams. It is fourth down, and the Texans are going to punt it away. Can Dom Booth do it again? Trying to pin the Chiefs back deep in their own territory. It's going to go out of bounds at the 4, so he does even better this time. The Chiefs only need a field goal to get the lead here in the fourth quarter, and they have all their timeouts. A minute 43 left. They hit Tyreek Hill underneath. They hurry up to the line. A minute 30 left. Second and 2. Mahomes, right side to Clyde Edwards-Helaire. He's hit, he lost the ball. The Texans are on it. That is Dwayne Crisp. He's going to run this one back into the end zone, making this an 8-point Texans lead. With an extra point, they can go up 2 scores. Did Clyde Edwards-Helaire actually fumble the ball, though? Yes, he did. Jacoby Stevens making a huge play there. And Mahomes made the right read. Nobody really open. But Clyde Edwards-Helaire makes the big mistake, and Dwayne Crisp makes the Chiefs pay and runs it back in. So now the all-important extra point from Fairbairn is good. So the Texans go up 2 scores with a minute 20 left. But Mahomes has been great all game long besides those turnovers. And he has time and timeouts. So we've got stuff to work with. Quick throw over the middle. That is Eric Hauser. He has a first down. The Chiefs are going to hurry up to the line. A minute left. All day for Mahomes. Firing deep down the field for Tyreek Hill. He's got him all the way to the Texans 15. Unbelievable. The Chiefs are going to hurry up to the line instead of using any timeouts. 30 seconds left. Mahomes underneath right side, caught by Juan Maxwell. And they say he's down in bounds, so the Chiefs have to use a timeout. 25 seconds left. Mahomes all day. Finally moving. Going right side. Caught one-handed by Tyreek Hill. He's out of bounds at the 6 with 20 seconds left. 3rd and inches. Mahomes moving back and forth. Moving right now. Going underneath the gray, and he's into the end zone, making this a 1-score game and giving the Chiefs a chance at an onside kick. If you remember last season, the Texans got an onside kick, and the Chiefs returned the favor. And no, they can't. Byron Mitchell is on it. So the Texans can go victory formation and win this one. 47-45 here in an absolute thriller over the Kansas City Chiefs. We may have defeated the Chiefs here, but man, did Mahomes have a great game besides those turnovers. 468 yards, a 79% completion percentage, and 6 passing touchdowns. I do not want to play this team again, but we probably will have to in the postseason if we both end up making it. I mean, they're just that good of a team. Look at these receiving stats. Travis Kelce, Tyreek Hill both had over 100 yards, 147 for Kelce, 168 for Hill. And then Allen Lazard had 3 receiving touchdowns. Eric Hauser was their leading receiver coming into this game. And he didn't really do much because all the other guys were doing so well. On our side, Dwight Devine had a great game, really. No turnovers, 3 passing touchdowns. Wasn't his most efficient work, but he got the job done, especially on some of those deep balls finally. We had no ground game to speak of in this one really at all. I mean, Willis just got shut down after that hot start. Just couldn't get that going again. Devontae Adams, 96 yards, got a deep ball to him. Cole Beasley finally had an okay game. And Nico Collins, his only catch on the day, went for a touchdown. So I'm glad we were able to beat the Chiefs. We did accomplish that goal, so the entire defense will get 2,500 experience for their effort today. Wasn't their best effort, but they did the job. I mean, they got a safety to get the lead back in the fourth. They got a bunch of turnovers, including 2 defensive touchdowns. I'd say it was a decent defensive day. As we move on to some upgrades, you saw that Tyler Randall went ahead and went speed rusher. Sergio Fulton is going to go power rusher. We're trying to make these two better pass rushers. We do have Kyle Van Noy on a 1-year contract, so we got to develop these two into some decent backup pass rushers behind Andrew Van Ginkle and Adam Wiener. Jacoby Stevens is going to go ahead and go field general, but he gets 2 to his zone coverage anyway. Dwayne Crisp, who went ahead and recovered that fumble forced by Jacoby Stevens there late in the fourth quarter and returned it for a touchdown, we're going to go ahead and go hybrid, try to get his coverage up, and he gets 2 to zone instead of man, which is fine, I guess. Michael Barr, like we said in the game, he had a rough day, gave up 2 touchdowns to Allen Lazard, and then 1 to Tyreek Hill. We got to get him better in coverage. He does get 3 to zone. Ross Blacklock, we're going to go ahead and go power rusher, try to get him better at rushing the passer. He's already pretty solid at it, but why not make him the best he possibly can be at it? Martin Boyce, he has been hurt a couple of times this season. Hopefully he is able to stay healthy the rest of the way. We're going to go run stopper like we always do with him, because we're trying to make him the best run stopper in all of the NFL. Roman Davis, going to go ahead and go zone like we did with Michael Barr. We have been running more zone than man this season. We got to get our 2 corners on the same page, and now they both have better zone than man. Adrian Thurston is just an extra defensive lineman on the team right now, but he could be a valuable piece here in a season or two, so we got to get his skills a little more well-rounded. Block shedding goes up 3 by him. Garrett Wallow, getting him better in coverage, same kind of thing. He doesn't play too much right now, but next season he actually could be on the field a lot because Hightower is on the last year of his contract. So Garrett Wallow could be a guy we use a lot more next season. Desmond King, the guy who scored the first touchdown in the game with a pick 6. We're going to go ahead and go zone to try to get him even better at covering people. And he also gets 1 to his speed. He did end up earning AFC Defensive Player of the Week honors for his performance. 11 tackles, an interception that went for a pick 6. But we did, however, end up giving up the AFC Offensive Player of the Week honors to Patrick Mahomes. We do have an injury to talk about. That is Tyler Randall. He is going to be out with a PCL sprain, which really sucks because Kyle Van Noy has to miss 1 more week with his torn labrum. And the way things work in Madden, you have to have 2 players at left outside linebacker and 2 players at right outside linebacker that are healthy, and we do not have that, so we have to free up a roster spot there and go ahead and sign somebody who can play that spot, and it's going to be Curtis Weaver out of Boise State. He does have some power moves and is just 25 years old. We'll see what he can do in a limited amount of time, which might end up being just 1 game. We have a draft story here about right end Josh Barden. Not only is he a smart player on the field, he is also very intelligent off the field. He is 6'5", 269, 21 years old, has a 3rd or 4th round grade, has only moved up the board 4 spots. The physicals all look great. He can rush the passer a bit with C power moves. If the finesse move and block shed are decent, he could be a really good player and a steal there in the 3rd or 4th round, somebody who is high on my board. On to the annual award races, now that we are partway into the season. Patrick Mahomes leading the MVP race after what he did to us. No surprise there. The Coach of the Year race is led by Dan Campbell, who is now the head coach of the Denver Broncos in his first season, and he is ahead of John Medlock, who is there in second place. Ross Blacklock is currently leading the AFC Defensive Player of the Year race, He was in it last year but didn't end up winning it. Andrew Van Ginkle down there in 6th, he also has an outside shot at winning it. On to the Offensive Rookie of the Year race, Jalen Hartwell, last year's Heisman winner out of Ohio State, is leading. I thought he'd end up being a bust, but he is in front of guys like Joe Scott and Byron Mitchell, who are on our team. Defensive Rookie of the Year race in the AFC, Earl Wilson on the Chargers leads it, ahead of Roman Davis and Antonio Binns, who was the first pick in the draft there for the Denver Broncos. We will be taking on the San Francisco 49ers next time. They made the playoffs last year, but the Chargers 4-5 this year. They have won 2 games in a row, including a win over the division-leading Arizona Cardinals. And after they play us, they play the Rams and Seahawks, so a quick turnaround is possible here for the 49ers. They have Trey Lance at quarterback. They have handed over the keys to the franchise to him. 17 touchdowns, just 4 interceptions, and a nice completion percentage of 69%. He is very athletic, has a big arm, can make the throws underneath. You have to force him to throw the ball down the field and hope that he makes mistakes. He is still pretty young. They do have a bunch of decent running backs there, Trey Sermon and Elijah Mitchell. They also have fullback Kyle Juszczyk. So great options there in the backfield. At receiver, or tight end I should say, George Kittle. He has 9 touchdowns, 774 yards, leads the team in receptions. He's a 99 overall superstar X factor. Great speed, good blocking, good hands. He can do everything on the football field. Same thing here with Deebo Samuel. He is their number 2 option, I guess, in the passing game here in our franchise. He's not quite as good as he is in real life here in Madden, but he is still really good. Has good speed, good hands, can run a bunch of routes, good after the catch. So yeah, the 49ers got studs all over the place on offense, but the offensive line is a little weak now that they lost Trent Williams at left tackle, so we could take advantage of that. The defense for the 49ers, it is loaded. They have Nick Bosa, who is a 98 overall superstar X-factor, and one of the best pass rushers in all the NFL. The defensive line in general is loaded. Kinlaw, Hurst, Rush, all great. And there's Eric Armstead. Could be a problem for us all game long, especially with, at times, our offensive line playing very poor. Fred Warner at middle linebacker, another 98 overall superstar X-factor on the defense. He could cover the entire field there. You got to be careful with him. If I had to pick a weakness on this defense, it would be cornerback. They don't have any great ones, but they do have 2 veteran safeties over the top, so you got to be careful with them. The 49ers roster is really good, and it's going to be another very tough game for us. We are currently 7-1, and are the top dogs in the AFC, in the NFL in general. We have to try to keep pace and keep doing what we're doing. Dwight Devine finally has a positive touchdown to interception ratio, so we have to try to keep that up, and hopefully he can take advantage of the 49ers corners and burn them down the field. Defensively, we just got to keep everybody in front of us and force the 49ers to move the ball very slowly. We can't let Kittle break a bunch of big plays. We also can't let that happen with Deebo Samuel, so we'll do the best we can. Next down, we're going to be taking on the San Francisco 49ers. Thanks for watching this one. Hopefully you enjoyed. And enjoy the Super Bowl. I will see you next time.